Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, is directed by Gareth Edwards. This Star Wars film is not one of the episode movies, though it is part of the same Star Wars story. It falls between Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, and Episode 4, A New Hope. It is the eighth Star Wars film to be released. Rogue One stars Felicity Jones as Jyn Erso, Diego Luna as Cassian Andor, Alan Tudyk as K2SO, Donnie Yen as Chirrut, Wen Jiang as Baze, Riz Ahmed as Bodhi, Mads Mikkelsen as Galen Erso, Ben Mendelsohn as Director Orson Krennic, Forrest Whitaker as Saul Guerrera, Genevieve O'Reilly as Mon Mothma, Jimmy Smits as Bail Organa, Spencer Wilding as Darth Vader, and James Earl Jones as the voice of Darth Vader. This film is rated PG-13 for extended sequences of sci-fi action and violence. I would say this movie is probably okay for people 10 years of age and older. The film has a runtime of 2 hours and 13 minutes. Rogue One was released in theaters in the United States on Friday, December 16, 2016. Research scientist Galen Erso and his family are hiding on the planet Lamu when Imperial weapons developer Orson Krennic arrives to press him into completing the Death Star, a space station-based superweapon capable of destroying entire planets. Galen's wife Lyra is killed in the confrontation while their daughter Jyn escapes and is rescued by a rebel extremist, Saul Guerrera. 13 years later, cargo pilot Bodhi Rook deflects from the Empire, taking a holographic message recorded by Galen to Guerrera on the desert moon of Jeddah. After learning about the Death Star from an agent at the trading outpost Ring of Kaffreen, Rebel Alliance intelligence officer Cassian Andor frees Jyn from an Imperial labor camp at Wobbany before bringing her to the Rebel leader Mon Mothma, who convinces her to find and rescue Galen so the Alliance can learn more about the Death Star. Cassian is covertly ordered to kill Galen rather than extract him. Jyn, Cassian, and reprogrammed Imperial droid that now belongs to the Rebels, K2SO, travel to Jeddah, where the Empire is removing kyber crystals from the holy city to power the Death Star, while Guerrera and his partisans are engaged in an armed insurgency against them. With the aid of blind spiritual warrior Chirrut and his mercenary friend Baze, Jyn makes contact with Guerrera, who has been holding Rook captive. Guerrera shows her the message in which Galen reveals he has secretly built a vulnerability into the Death Star and directs them to retrieve the schematics from an Imperial databank on the planet Scarif. On the Death Star, Krennic orders a low-powered test shot which destroys Jeddah's capital city. Jyn and her group take Rook and flee the moon, but Guerrera remains to die with the city. Grand Moff Tarkin congratulates Krennic before using Rook's defection and security leak as a pretext to take control of the Death Star project. Rook leads the group to Galen's Imperial Research Facility on the planet of Edu, where Cassian chooses not to kill Galen. Jyn makes her presence known moments before rebel bombers attack the facility. Galen is mortally wounded by the bombers and dies in his daughter's arms before she escapes with her group on board an Imperial cargo shuttle. Krennic is then summoned by Darth Vader to answer for the attack on Edu. Krennic seeks his support for an audience with the Emperor, but Vader instead orders him to ensure no further breaches occur. Jyn proposes a plan to steal the Death Star schematics using the Rebel fleet, but fails to gain the approval from the Alliance Council, who feel victory against the Empire is now impossible. Frustrated at their inaction, Jyn's group lead a small squad of rebel volunteers to raid the databank themselves. Arriving at Scarif on the stolen Imperial ship, which Rook dubs the name Rogue One, a disguised Jyn and Cassian enter the base with K2SO while the other rebels attack the Imperial garrison as a diversion. The rebel fleet learns of the raid from intercepted Imperial communications and deploys in support. K2SO sacrifices himself so Jyn and Cassian can retrieve the data. Chirrut is killed after activating the master switch to allow communication with the rebel fleet, and Baze is killed in action shortly thereafterwards. Bodhi is killed by a grenade after informing the rebel fleet that it must deactivate the shield surrounding the planet to allow the transmission of the schematics. Jin and Cassian obtain the schematics, but they are ambushed by Krennic, who is eventually shot and wounded by Cassian. Jin transmits the schematics to the Rebel command ship. The Death Star enters orbit above Scarif, where Tarkin uses another low-power shot to destroy the compromised base, killing Krennic, Cassian, and Jin. The Rebel fleet prepares to jump to hyperspace, but many of the fleet's ships are intercepted by Vader's flagship. Vader boards the Rebel command ship and attempts to regain the schematics, but a small starship escapes with the plans on board. Aboard the fleeing ship, Princess Leia declares that the schematics will provide hope for the rebellion. Okay, so now let's talk about my negatives for this movie. I did not see or think that this film had very many negatives. However, I wish at the film's opening that the film would have had an opening crawl like all the other Star Wars movies. The character development could have been a little bit better. All in all, it was okay. I just think they could have done a little bit better with some of the major and some of the minor characters as well. I would like to have seen more scenes with Darth Vader besides the two sequences we got, which were so awesome and badass. I like how we get to see Jimmy Smits as Bail Organa again. I just wish we would have had a few more scenes with him as well. Other than that, I really didn't see any other flaws in this film. I know there probably were some, I just didn't notice them. Okay, so let's talk about the positives of this film. I'm so glad this movie exists because this is a story I've always wanted to see in the Star Wars universe on the big screen and in live action. The Rebels stealing the Death Star plans, and man, it's a great story. I really liked it. I love the cameo of Princess Leia Organa at the film's end, and also the cameo scenes of Peter Cushing's Grand Moff Tarkin character. This is the first Star Wars movie in which John Williams does not do the score to. However, his Star Wars themes are utilized at times in this film. The score for this Star Wars film is done by Michael Giacchino, who did films like Star Trek 2009, Star Trek Into Darkness, Star Trek Beyond, Jurassic World, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, Spider-Man Homecoming, Spider-Man Far From Home, and Doctor Strange. The film utilizes a lot of the Star Wars looks from the original and sequel trilogies. The film also references things from Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith as well. I love this film. It is one of the best films in the saga. So when this movie first came out, I went with my Aunt Cindy to see this movie in San Angelo, Texas. And afterwards, we went out to eat at IHOP. So I just wanted to quickly say thank you, Aunt Cindy, for a wonderful evening of Star Wars and pancakes. Okay, so let's talk about my grade for Rogue One. My final grade for Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, it gets a very strong A. If you are a Star Wars fan and you have not seen this movie, shame on you. It's totally worth the time and the money. I have it in my collection on both Blu-ray and DVD. If you haven't checked it out, you're missing out on a great Star Wars story and just great action, adventure, sci-fi fun. Okay, so that's my review for Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. If you're new to the video, go down to the bottom of the video, click the subscribe button. Also, hit the thumbs up and give this video a like, and also hit the notification bell so you'll know when I have new videos posted. Also, give me some great comments. What do you think about Rogue One? And are you excited about The Rise of Skywalker? So anyway, thank you so much for watching. God bless you all. I love you. And Merry Christmas.
Director Krennic.
Lord Vader.
You seem unsettled.
No, just pressed for time. There's a great many things to attend to.
My apologies. You do have a great many things to explain.
I delivered the weapon the Emperor requested. I deserve an audience to make certain that he understands its remarkable potential.
Its power to create problems has certainly been confirmed. A city destroyed. An Imperial facility openly attacked.
It was Governor Tarkin that suggested the test.
You were not summoned here to grovel, Director Krennic.
No, it's...
There is no Death Star. The Senate has been informed that Jeddah was destroyed in a mining disaster.
Yes, my lord.
I expect you not to rest until you can assure the Emperor that Galen Erso has not compromised this weapon in any way.
So I'm still in command? You'll speak to the Emperor about it.
Be careful not to choke on your aspirations, Director.